this is an overly simplified formula for the speed of sound, and you know, shouldn't be taken, you know, and used for critical activities. But for our purposes, it's fine. So we essentially have a formula that's 331 meters per second plus 0.6 meters per second per 1 degree Celsius times the temperature in Celsius. Our temperature at the time we tested was 59 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 15 degrees C. We plugged that into the equation for the speed of sound, and we got 340 meters per second. We took it as 1,115 feet per second. The next speed we need to know is the velocity of the pellet leaving the pellet gun. The muzzle velocity in the user manual of a 30-year-old pellet gun was 400 feet per second. So that's the number we used. So pellet to balloon, we had to figure out how much time it would take. So we used the formula D equals RT, distance equals rate times time, something we all learned in high school, maybe earlier now. So 33 feet, pellet to balloon, so pellet gun to the balloon, 33 feet, equals 400 feet per second times T for time. We saw for time, T equals 0.0825 seconds. The time sound took to travel to the iPhone, it had to go 30 feet. So sound started here, goes 30 feet to the iPhone. Again, fill out the equation, D equals RT. We got 0.0269 seconds. The delta T, or difference in time, is simply one subtracting the other and taking the absolute value. So we had 0.0825 seconds minus 0.0269 seconds gave us a difference of 0.0556 seconds for our flash delay. This is what you would typically plug into trigger trap for the flash delay, but you can't do that exactly because it's going to take a good 1/4,000 of a second for the iPhone to communicate with the flashes to fire. Not a long time, but if you took 0.4 of a second off, you would be down to 0.0516 seconds. So it does make a difference. And what we found was that we had to be somewhere between 0.38 and 0.48 to get it just right. This is probably because this number in the user manual for the pellet velocity, you know, is not very accurate. It was just one data point in the user manual. It's the gun's 30 years old. Also, from where we fired, it tended to vary up to a couple of feet forward or back, depending on how I was set up. So again, it's not like we had our pellet gun on a fixed stand where it never moved. So we had some variables, but it got us close. So two shots, we were able to dial it in instead of 10 to 20 shots without using any math. So this is the math behind it. I would highly recommend, you know, going through the exercise. I have had a couple of teachers ask about the math behind it. They would like to show their students, work through the problem. Here it is, simple math. Again, an oversimplified formula for the speed of sound in the Earth's atmosphere. And a quick bit of trivia is that the speed of sound in water is roughly 4 times as fast as it is in the air we breathe. So again, you could have skip this video, that'd be just fine. Go on to the next one, to the setup, but this will help you dial in your flash delay with trigger trap. Alternatively, what I could have done is the 560TX transmitter and iPhone could have went next to the pellet gun. That would have removed the need to calculate the speed of sound because then the sound would have happened at the gun, so it would have been negligible. Then we'd have only had to calculate how long does it take the pellet to travel to the balloon, and that would have become our flash delay. And that's how I would do it again. I would have put the transmitter and iPhone next to the pellet gun instead of near the flashes and the balloon. Because when the transmitter fires, it fires via radio wave, and radio waves move right at the speed of light. So it's near instant. That would be the one change I would have made to our setup. Hope you enjoyed the quick math lesson.